Thank you. And ladies and gentlemen, good morning, and thanks for coming here today to listen to us. I will use my 20 minutes to introduce Cadogan and tell you who we are, what we have achieved over the last few years, and particularly how much the company has changed since its early days, and what our strategy is. Before moving into the presentation, I will just add a few words to introduce myself. The 30 years I've been with Eni, so I think one of the largest oil companies, and today, besides my job at the helm of Cadogan, I'm also an advisor to the energy practice of the Boston Consulting Group. Now, let me move to the next. I will not spend a lot of time on this disclaimer. God bless the councils, and move to the next slide. Who we are? Well, we are a small company, an E&P company, which has been listed in the main market of the stock exchange here in London since 2008, and has all its assets located in Ukraine. We practically have no debt. We have nearly £37 million cash, and a market cap which is only about £17 million. And this, as you can imagine, is something which myself and my team are not very happy with. And I will return on this topic towards the end of my presentation. As for the share price, it has kept declining. I cannot show you the twofold, the threefold increases that some other CEO have been presenting. The company is following the trend of other companies which were established in the late 90s in order to exploit the riches of the former CIS countries after the fall of the Iron War. And I have to say, with many expectations unmissed. And finally, our shareholders, which are listed at the bottom right of the table, are there. And I have to say, this group of shareholders has remained pretty stable over the last 4 or 5 years. Now, today, we manage three businesses. First, what has been and still remains our core business, which is E&P operations. We operate 6 licenses in Ukraine, plus another two actually, which are under renewal. And we produce about 120 barrels oil equivalent per day, oil and gas. We also have a 15% carried interest with 9 shale gas licenses operated by Eni in the west of the country. And Eni is the only major operator in Ukraine of shale gas after the decision of Shell and Chevron to pull out. All these licenses, and I want to be clear, are far away from the war zone. Our operations have not been affected by the confrontation with Russia. In particular, the producing licenses are close to the border with the European Union. We then have a service business, which is probably odd for a company of our size, but we provide the services, different kind of services, to operators in Ukraine. And it is an activity which started to make use of the equipment and the skill learned by our staff over the time, which were in excess to the reduced level of current operations. And I think it's an indication of the ingenuity of this company and their people. I mean, put at use whatever was left from the old days. Today, this sort of startup is contributing significantly to the profit of the company and is contributing to paying our bills. Lastly, and this is probably something you heard, we have a gas trading activity which started, and this I think is important, as an opportunistic way to use some of the cash we had while waiting to find opportunities in which to invest it. Some of this cash was used to support the credit lines in Ukraine, and we were able to enter the market at a very early stage when arbitrage margins were high, and therefore over the last couple of years also trading has been a significant contributor to our P&L. One question which I've been asked a number of times, and I want to reassure our shareholders, the credit line is in Ukraine, but it is backed by money kept in the UK bank account, so we did not move money there. We have a credit line in Ukraine, and this money can be released and back at any time if we have another opportunity to invest it. Now, after introducing the company, I will spend the next 10 minutes presenting our achievements, as these achievements, in my view, as a newcomer, I've been with the company for a year, are probably the best way to tell those of you who have known the old Cadogan how much this company has changed over the last few years. I mean, as the first achievement, I would say the Cadogan has kept production stable, and actually, it has been able to increase it. It's 20% year on year on the last semester. Volumes are small. I cannot pretend we have the 4 and 5 digits, but I mean, increasing production on these very mature and marginal fields by 20% has been anything but easy, and it's a demonstration of good reservoir management practice and good asset integrity knowledge. As far as I recall, our broker at the beginning of the year made an assessment of the current production, and we had an evaluation of £3 million NPV. Then our production is supported by a decent reserves base, which stands at 23 million. You may go down to 8 million if we put aside a couple of licenses which are undergoing the renewal process. But for that level of production, whether we are 23 or 8 million of 3P, I think we have the reserves necessary to continue increasing slightly our production base. These reserves have been assessed by a Ukrainian consulting company. The numbers perhaps don't have the hype of earlier evaluations which were made by Gaffney and Klein, but I can tell you that they are reasonable and they are robust. The second achievement is that we have gone to, I would say, really great efforts to make the company leaner and more efficient. Over the last 3 years, we have been able to reduce G&A and OPEX by more than 40%, which means achieving combined savings of 10 million. And these savings are approximately divided between 70-75% into G&A and 20-25% into OPEX. How did we make it? I mean, certainly that the devaluation of the Ukrainian hryvnia has played a role, but it played it primarily in the first years. More recently, the driver for reducing the cost at this level have been a right-sizing of the company. We took note of what we are and the assets we have and aligned the organization. We have been replacing expatriates, expensive expatriates, with local engineers and accountants and managers. We have relocated the office a number of times, and today we still have offices in the central district of Kiev. We no longer have an office in London. And if you ever come to Kiev, you will see that there is very little marble in our office and a lot of open space. Even the CEO has an open space for his desk. And lastly, over the last few months, we have called all of our provider of a corporate type of service, auditing, legal counseling, and we have renegotiated many of the contracts with them, securing a discount. Now, all these efforts combined with the margin, the earnings from the non-E&P business, so gas trading and services, And with a relentless effort in order to optimize the working capital, allow us to preserve cash to a great extent. What I want to highlight at this stage, that all these efforts to save money here and there has not come at the expenses of the safety in our workplaces or of our attentiveness to the environment. Quite proud of the achievements of my colleagues and my predecessor as CEO, because the company did not have one single LTI or TRI for 4 years, and only recently we had an LTI because of a guy acting against procedure, but even against instructions. In terms of emission to the atmosphere, we have been able in the last 3 years to halve our level of emissions in comparison to what we had in 2013. The third achievement, which I want to share with you, is that in a way, even though the share price has been declining and we're not happy about it, I mean, we have been able to mitigate this decline. It may not be much, but it is still, I think, an important achievement. And we have been comparing ourselves with, two benchmarks. One is the group of companies which are operating in Ukraine, on something I call a geographic benchmark. And another is a group of companies listed here in London in the AIM index for oil and gas. Now, if you look at the slides, you will see that we clearly outperform our Ukrainian peers, which are described by this light blue area. And we have more or less closely matched the AIM index. As I said, I think it's not a bad achievement, but it is also something that we do not celebrate, because as you probably recall, our share price is worth less than the prorated value of the cash we have in the banks. And then if you think that on top of the cash, we have the production, we have the reserves, we have the resources, we have the income from trading and services, we have tax losses, we have credits. I mean, it is something which actually fills me in a position where I have to do something, and both myself and my team are committed to make a change. Now, this is what we have achieved, and I would spend the last minutes of my time introducing the strategy, because I think also the strategy is something which those of you who have known the company from the early days will see as a mark of the difference in this company. First and foremost, our strategy is to reload our portfolio. And the reloading has two objectives. First is to add some production, to have a low risk, perhaps low value, but low risk cash flow, which will allow Cadogan to self-finance itself in the exploration investments. And the second objective is to add high impact pre-development assets which are underpriced. And then we will use the revenues for production. Oops. Running too fast. To mitigate or remove the underpricing factors with the objective of reselling or farming out these assets with the capital gain. And this capital gain, in my view, is the polar star. I mean, we need to return our shareholders some of the money they lost in the previous years. In terms of assets, what are our search domain? I mean, definitely we need to reposition the portfolio of Ukraine, of Cadogan outside of Ukraine. I'm not saying we don't like Ukraine. I'm not saying that we want to exit Ukraine. I'm just saying that we don't think it is prudent to keep all our eggs in one single Ukrainian basket, particularly so nowadays. So we will look at a number of countries, primarily countries where myself, the board, the other management team members have direct experience, knowledge, and contacts. And these identify a pretty broad space, which includes Europe, North Africa, Sub-Saharan Africa, and Central Asia. These are our focus area. In terms of type of assets we are looking, we want to be realistic. So we search for something which is within our means. We have the skills to do it and the resources to do it. So conventional types of assets, no shale, gas, shale oil. The only exception is are these licenses we have in Ukraine, but operated by Eni. And either onshore or in shallow water. We will not test our skill and our luck with deep water exploration or exploitation of unconventional. Finally, in pursuing our strategy, which is to reload our portfolio with a clearly defined typology of assets in a number of geographic areas well-defined, we will use the levers we have, and these levers are a lean, cost-efficient organization, which can produce safely and efficiently marginal fields. And then, I don't know how to say in English, but so our geographic knowledge of a number of countries. Then, the second pillar of our strategy is to continue trading with gas. Now, it's an activity, as I said, which has delivered quite good results. It has been a very efficient way of using capital which we had in the bank. We certainly generated a much higher return. But as Ukraine moves towards stability and introduces regulations, I mean, the market is becoming more structured and more mature, and the margins are getting tighter and tighter. So we don't see today the margin we had a couple of years ago. That being said, I think we have developed over the years some competencies which we want to retain, because they will come handy when we have our own production with at least one more digit to the three we have now to sell. And lastly, few words on the service businesses. We will also continue growing this service business, but unlike what we plan for gas trading, the idea we have here is to spin it off and sell it. But sell it at the right time and at the right price. And today, I don't think it would be the right time and the price would not be the right one, particularly because this service business has been providing services to international foreign investors, foreign companies, and today there are few of them in Ukraine. So I don't think we can capture the maximum value of a company which can conjugate Western standards in terms of safety accounting procedures with knowledge of the local context. Conclusions. I put down six bullets, and perhaps there is more, but I think, in my view, this is the way to summarize our key message for today. Cadogan is no longer the company it was, and the company you may have heard in the past. We have embarked in a long transformational journey, and now we have a lean, cost-efficient organization rooted in Ukraine, where we have a competent and loyal workforce at a fraction of the cost you would incur in any other West Europe country. Second, and this is somewhat related to the first point, we have preserved cash. Cost consciousness has not been the only means to preserve it. As I share with you, we have been demonstrated our ability to make opportunistic uses of the resources which were left from the old days. and of making use of the financial resources which were sitting in a bank without putting these financial resources at risk. Because I repeat, the money, the 37 million pounds, are safely held in UK banks. These non-core businesses are part, of, as we have seen, of our value proposition, but the core of our value proposition remains to pursue high-impact pre-development assets which are undervalued and which we can then farm out or sell once we have been able to mitigate the underpricing factors. We are actively searching, pursuing opportunities which are adequately priced, and this is the key issue, fit into our strategy, and are within our means. I think since I joined the company, we have probably reviewed at least 24 of opportunities, and we have not been able, as you all know, to finalize any of them, primarily because of an issue related to the evaluation. And this is the following point I have. I think I have to admit that when I took the job, I was a bit more optimistic. I thought that there would be plenty of opportunities available to reload the portfolio, as many other experts were expecting. But what I have witnessed over the last few months is something which I never seen in my previous 35 years in the industry. I mean, on the one end, you have these potential sellers which are still failing to appreciate the impact of current prices on their evaluation, and this is normal to some extent. But on the other end, you have the borrowers which are extending lifeline to the lenders, which are extending this lifeline to the borrowers, waiving breaches of covenants. And from what I see from my perspective now, we are probably coming to the end of this period. And so, sooner rather than later, some opportunities, adequately priced, should become available. When they are available, we are well-funded. I mean, we have all the ammunition we need in order to implement our strategy of reloading the portfolio. We could do better if the market appreciated the real value of the company in the share price. Because don't want to say if, but when it will happen, we will be able to complement our cash with shares when trying to structure deals. And I think this takes to the end. If you let me, one final remark. I think gone are the days of Cadogan, as you can probably still find it if you browse the internet, of UBS big IPO for £140 million, of expensive wells being drilled without particularly positive results, of claiming calls with contractors, with our own management, of equipment bought and stored, which we are still using now after 10 years. I mean, we have reset it all. And today, humbly, but also proudly, we present for what we are, a small company, which is cost conscious, efficient, which can operate safely into marginal fields, and which has a strategy which we are actively pursuing. We are aware that in order to change this market perception, we need to build credibility, and there is a commitment from everyone in the company to demonstrate that we are no longer what you have known, and we have a strategy which we are all committed to implement. And I think with this, I finish my presentation, and I leave you the floor for questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Guido. Thank you. So a company that has changed a lot over the last few years. You've now got no debt, you're well-funded, you've cut costs, you've taken on cheaper local teams, you've outperformed your peers, and now you're seeking new opportunities that will broaden your firepower and also your appeal. Now, you mentioned that you're going to need to position yourself outside of the Ukraine. You mentioned regions like Africa, Middle East, etc. Are there any particular countries that are top of your shopping list?
Well, I mean, to the top of the list, there are assets which are undervalued. I mean, we are not focusing on one region in particular. And as I said, I mean, we have been struggling to find assets which, in our view, are priced adequately. I mean, out of the 2024 opportunities which we have reviewed, there is one which has hit the headlines here in London. It was our attempt to buy Ascent. I don't know whether it's because of our preliminary offer, but now the share price is 40% higher. And they have announced that their plan to dispose of the gas is not what it was when we approached them. So even though it is frustrating to see that after 1 year from planting the seeds, there is very little to harvest, this is not a reason for us to either relax our discipline or change the criteria we have in order to assess opportunities. I think the time is coming. After more than 2 years, one of my predecessors said that the expectation of price are not for the hundreds again. I believe that at the end of the day, discipline, rules will pay. And if I have to pick up a region, I mean, certainly North Africa, I've been working there for 6 years, Kazakhstan, but we need the right asset which can allow the company to generate capital gains of an order of magnitude which mitigate the past losses. We have a baggage behind.
So you're looking for the right asset, and not in a specific region or country. Any questions? The gentleman at the back, glasses.
If I was a shareholder in your company, I would be a little bit concerned with 50 million or 37 million in the bank. I could earn more in a bank account, and I will be seeking a capital return. I would also have a concern about the word diversification, because that's, you know, tends to be a dirty word. With a company like yours, that should be focusing on its core activities. You're moving into the service area, and you're kind of all over the place without a strategy. Whereas you say you have a strategy, I don't really think that you have. So one of the things that you might think about doing is focus on your core activities. The gas, you say, has got a lot of promise. Maybe spin off this service company as a separate concern. And we've seen a marvelous investment in Egypt, and they're short of funds. So perhaps you could be talking to SDX about undervalued assets in Egypt and coming to, you know, a strategy and consolidating and focusing more on your core activities.
Of course, there'll be an opportunity to have that conversation in the lunch break after.
I'll be talking to SDX. They need the money. You've got the money, and you can put something really spectacular.
Thank you. A quick response to the gentleman.
A quick may not be that quick because he has touched a number of issues. I mean, first and foremost, money is safe in a bank, as I said, and at least for what it is worth, now you have a company which is not burning this money. Second, I mean, Egypt, yes, it's an area which we have looked. I have been clearly instructed on what I can and what I cannot say in order to be compliant with these new regulations. But we have been looking to a number of companies which assets in Egypt. And we have been looking at both buying the company or buying the debt. It all goes down to buying something at a price which you think is reasonable, adequate, and leaves you some upside. When it comes to the strategy, I would disagree with you. We have a strategy. As I said, the pillar is to renew once and for all this portfolio. We have all licenses which have seen their better days. They can barely produce 120 barrels with a lot of efforts. I mean, we invested a lot of money. Eni invested a lot of money, and unfortunately, the results are what they are. So we need to reload the portfolio, and this is what we're doing. We're not being distracted by gas trading and services. The services is something which I said myself, in our strategy, we want to spin it off. But I don't want to give it away for free. I mean, these services is nothing else than using money which the old shareholders gave to Cadogan to buy pipes, rigs, vessels, separators, which have never been used. They're sitting there. And gas trading is, as I said, an opportunistic way to make use of the cash. If we find an opportunity to buy and we need the money, we release it immediately. But I wouldn't say that this is a lack of sense of direction. It's probably the other way around. It's trying to put a sense of direction after so many years.
Guido, thank you very much for refinding your navigation, setting out your strategy and refocusing.
It is difficult. I mean, I cannot pretend it's an easy journey, but probably it is of no importance to you, but it's the very reason why I'm here. They offer me this challenge. I understand it's not easy, but at my age, I still need something which really has to be strong to feel the motivation and the interest and the enthusiasm. And I think that there are all the ingredients here to make it.
And you've achieved a lot already in the last 3 years. Well, Guido, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much. Guido from Cadogan Petroleum.